Portuguese warriors. They're always like to be called. And we actually have a 3-stack on B here, so the CT's playing a little bit safe. They're expecting a heavy B rush, and we can see that the bomb is going up second mid, so not the exact call that Alien Techno wants. Scream does see one at the bottom of mid. He's gonna get challenged in a second. No, actually he does pull back here. The bomb is right by Haystacks. We have a little bit of damage and Braden going on towards Banana right now, as the rest of the terrorists do start to regroup up towards mid. So it looks like it's going to be an A execute. And there's still 3 on B. One of the players, Zit, is doing a fantastic job here of keeping those 3 players at B. So there's no rotate coming out of them. It's going to be a 4v2. A nice pop flash coming out by Scream. He gets a great spinning shot there as he comes around the corner. But he gets traded out by Experience. 3 of them are still on B, and the bomb is rotating there. We have 2 flankers coming from CT, which is going to be a very big deal. Do they have the information? Yes, they're kind of hiding right now, so I believe they do. Slinks gets one, gets a second, and Zlend gets the third. The last one's on Ruins, and he will fall. Zinks, Blinks, is that how it's pronounced? Gets a sick triple headshot kill that round, and easily wins it for Alien Tech. I think also it's cool to have a look at odds on CSGO, so you kind of have an idea of who the matchup favors. I believe it was something like 55% to Alien Tech and like 45% to Dope. So does indicate that it could have a close game. Of course, sometimes it doesn't end up being that. We have an execute towards B right now, as all 5 of the terrorists are making their way up. We only have 2 CTs this time, so they're, you know, they're not in the same as last round, but they do have the rifles, and the terrorists are lining up. Slinks gets 2 great headshots. His teammates in the corner back him up, forming a crossfire. And the terrorists, they do get Slinks. Will they get another one? No, they will not. As Zlin will finish them off. And Slinks has got 6 kills in 2 rounds, so 3 kills apiece for him. So we'll keep our eye on him. He could be the carry here for this game. Third round, no bomb plant as of yet, so the terrorists are not going for a buy. They are going to start taking a lot of damage almost immediately here, as a nade stack does take out one of them. Second one falling, third, a CT has been traded in return, but it's not enough just yet. And they do have 2 P250, so if they can get a couple kills, just make it expensive. They will be happy with that. Unfortunately, only getting one, which would be Scream. I don't know exactly what gun he had either, so I don't think it was that big of a loss. Scream picking up the AWP now, as he did lose his rifle or SMG last round. The AK is coming out of T side, so they're going for their first buy. And because they forced up with pistols and stuff like that, they haven't gotten the kills with it, so they are limited on utility with their nades. Oh, great shot there by Scream, taking out Benji. Down by ramp. And that kind of stops the terrorists just stone cold. Like they stop executing, they just, I guess they kind of want to get that return frag before they decide what site they would like to hit up. But just some trading going on. Ore drops down to 15, as I think Scream deals some good damage to him. Another shot there on to Zend, and that drops him down to 18, so, oh, he's going back for it. But he decides not to. The bomb is on one of the players here, so they're moving towards A. It looks like they're finally deciding to execute. They have a minute yet left, and the last guy from Banana's regrouping, so it definitely looks like they're going to start doing this. They have 2 smokes and a flash, so they really don't have a crazy amount of utility. They're starting to pop some of them out. But with 2 players at 15 health, pretty much, it's, you know, it's just one dink from them onto them, and they're dead. Ooh, Scream takes a little bit of damage, does get pushed back, gets the shot, has to run away because he's about to get peeked, and he will get the kill anyway, so great move from him. And the third one is very, very close. He nearly hits it. Doesn't connect. His teammate does save him, and of course he gets the assist since he shot him earlier on. And pretty straightforward cleanup. I think only 2 terrorists died. Oh, sorry, 1 CT died. Like, so they're banking the money now as well. This is where it starts, you know, Like, if it starts to snowball within the game, this is where it has to be stopped. So, we have a Tech 9, armor, rush, and the terrorists know that grenade stack up mid does get a kill there onto Zildjian, which is actually pretty good, but Scream gets returned with the AWP. Famine some needs in mid. The terrorists are all up here, so it looks like they do want to go for this A site. And okay, Bloods gets the first one as they come around the corner. The second one lines up, he gets wrecked. Third one falls to him as well, and then Scream gets the last remainder one as he nearly takes out his teammate. Nicely done. Like, that was a bit of a meat grinder, and that was a Tech 9 armor buy, so that was... You know, that wasn't exactly a cheap run that they, couldn't get any kills, so... That's a big deal, but we have, once again, another buy, and there's going to be an AWP this time on the C... Oh, sorry, the Terrace side. So, want to see how they can make this work. Benji's just covering mid with it, making sure no one flanks him. We also got another terrorist towards second mid, just making sure that they don't get flanked. But Zelin gets his first kill, gets the second. His teammate backs or runs out to back him up, but he gets taken out and he will get the return frag. So now it's a 2v4. And each team has an AWP, so that's nothing significant really at this stage. Bomb is down as well behind the smoke, so now they're... Like, they kind of have to stay here, or just wander off and save. I guess they're gonna try and bait them out to... Just get some kills. I think they know they're in a very tough spot. Flame does get chucked out there. Trains on Benji. We can see Scream and Benji right now just zoning each other out. Scream peeks us, which he kind of... Oh, no. Benji's gonna come up. He gets whacked. Getting a bit impatient. Pop flash coming out of Zendi. Smoke as well. Did he just get picked off through the smoke? I was watching his teammate, but it looked like that was just a straight up through the smoke shot there. I don't know if his teammate got some info with that jump and kind of saw him on the radar and went off that, but great shot there. So Scream, he is also doing fantastic. Slinx hasn't had any kills since the second round, but they haven't really gone B, so that's fine. He's doing a great job there of just holding the site, not leaving it. We have a Tech 9 rush here with some armor towards A. And they're moving quite fast. I like this. You know, you want to get on top of your opponents in their faces with the Tech 9. You don't want to have long range duels. And Zeta will get the first kill here onto Scream. That's the AWP through the smoke as well with a headshot. But he gets picked off from guy in library. Or peeking the angle. Bomb does get dropped. CT gets taken out. Who did that? And oh, the one on site does win the duel there. Against, I think that was against Experience. And Stinks comes from B, pops out of library, gets absolutely wrecked. And finally, the terrorists win their first round, so they'll put themselves onto the scoreboard. And they'll, you know, have a sigh of relief, I guess, for that. You know, at least it's not like a 16-0 guaranteed, right? A little bit of something there for them, a glimpse of hope. But yeah, the CT's also had a decent bank going into that. They have, you know, a full buy, completely full buy. No one's missing anything. And Scream does have that AWP, so he's the, you know, the team AWP here. And he's been doing a great job of it as well. The AWP for the terrorist Endy was just holding the angle at mid there in case one of them peeked him. And that's what they're doing. They've got a full buy, they've got an AWP, so they're working on picks right now. Oh, Scream gets the first pick there. It looked like Experience just popped out of boiler room and gets whacked as a response. The Scream is a very good AWP, in all fairness to him. And does a good job of rotating around, so he's always very predictable. They don't know where he's going to be to try and pre-aim him, flash him out, smoke him. Got one terrorist on banana, just keeping these CTs there because, like, we can see here, it looks like they're more than likely going to execute towards A. Zit runs all the way down banana. He's bought himself and his team a little bit of time. 4v5 right now, and it's a 4v3 going into this execute, so... Yeah, with the favor, the odds are in the favor of the terrorist side. First kill going to Zil, as he does pick off all that with a great headshot. Zit getting a return frag. He comes onto balcony. He gets another kill before being traded. And, oh, Zendid with the AWP picks off Slinks. And now we have Zaleen. You know, 2v1, sees one of them on site. He knows where he is. Second one, he also knows, gets popped through the smoke. Zendid had that pre-aimed really nicely. And I think the shots coming through the smoke just triggered him to pull that trigger. And yeah, he gets the kill. That was like 2 kills, 2 smokes there. What beasts. It's kind of amazing whenever you like play matchmaking, if you get killed through smoke, you're like, oh my god, like back. But when you actually see how often pros do it, you're just like, wow. Like, all right, so Flame does get chucked down here. CT's playing very aggressive on Banana. The AWP is forward, so he has to be careful. Nearly getting a collateral. I think it may have hit that CT, actually. And now it was a 2-on-1. He gets the trade there on Banana. The last CT is moving down mid. And he does get scouted. Gets the kill, though, onto Experience through the side of the wall. I don't know if they know that the bomb is in Mexico. That's why the CT right now is running. He knew that the other guy was on ramp and had to cross that angle. So that's why he held it. But he doesn't know the bomb is down and they had to come back to get it. And Zendy doesn't know that he didn't know where the bomb was. So he picks up the bomb. He's going to head towards B, which Bloods is anticipating because he thought he went banana with the bomb. But he actually had to go back and get it. Of course, Zendy does have a smoke. Drops it to cover CT, plants the bomb, goes towards Spindles, Spools, whichever you may want to call it, and they will have a confrontation in a second. Who will win it? Zendy takes him out and gets dope the third round of the match here. So we have 3 rounds together right now. You know, to lose 6, win 1 is good, but then to lose the next one is a very, you know, big deal for the Terra side. So to carry on the momentum and win those 2 rounds is absolutely fantastic for them. They're going into round number 4 up against, you know, upgraded pistols and stuff like that. So this should be theirs. This should be a 6-4 scoreline. And yeah, so we just have like a CZ, P250s, and a couple deagles. So just have upgraded pistols. Oh, then Zendid picks the corner, gets the kill into the little Lynx. And we have just 1 CT left. Ooh, another pick off there towards A. As the Terra start pushing a bit forward. There's still smoke and utility around, so they have to be a bit careful. And ooh, Blood's coming out of Boiler Room. Gets a bit of damage done. Does get taken out. And then we saw Zaleen taken out. Oh, and now he has an AK. He does have armor. He has 9 health though, so unfortunately he's still in a ridiculously tough position, but if he can get like maybe 1 more kill, I think he could be kind of happy with that. If he can get this, he can still survive, but he's not gonna have much health. Seat gets the kill, gets the AK. I don't know what gun he had then, but I think he just swapped it. He's like, I want this skin now. And all right, so we're going into another buy round. This is where Alien Tech needs to also shut their opponent's momentum down. Because if it goes up to 6v5, they're on another eco. That's going to be 6-6. And then it's anyone's game. And they're on the hardest side. Scream does get the first pick off on mid here, so he's going to be happy with that. The Terrorists are just playing a more controlled, slow round this time. And nice little stack there by Quad up on A. Some of the players. Yeah, I wonder if this works out. So we got sealed. A pop flash just gets popped out. They're holding the angle. He drops down, expecting one to come apartments. And he leaves his teammate Dead Bloods to just get wrecked. He did get a frag beforehand though, so he did his job. 3 terrorists left. They're all standing right next to each other, so they could be lined up. Scream gets one. Gonna get the second. No, he will fall. Benji. Dave and his teammate, but there's two on site. And the third is flanking, but oh man, now it's down to a 2v1. The bomb is being planted. Zaleen by himself with a smoke and a flame. Oh, he gets the kill as Benji pulls out a smoke there. And the smoke actually lands on site. Kind of benefiting Zaleen a little bit. Oh, he's in the flame. He thought he got out of it. Oh, this is a great move here. I see it. Oh, that flame was not the best. That could have actually had him there. It looks like he's going to save the AWP, realize it. No. Save an M4. Oh, yeah, sorry. He does save the AWP. Oh, and then he dies anyway. So great, great job there from ZT. Is it ZT? We're going to call him Zit anyway. Great job. Make sure that AWP doesn't get saved. Like, you know, that's a very, very expensive skin. And if you can save that with some armor and, you know, a pistol needs utility, even better so. Alright, so we have a bit of a force coming out of the CTs here. Not much utility. 4 Famuses and an M4. They realize, like, they cannot allow Dope to take the, or tie the game right here. And, okay, the first one does get picked off. Things eating a headshot there from Oars. He nearly did get zipped by peeking around that corner. The bomb is coming towards B. One is rotated to CT as well to back up their teammates. And he is spamming through the smoke. This is going to cause the terrorists to rotate. Okay, maybe just 1 or 2. Like, they had the opening frag, so they have some wiggle room now. You know, they could push on A. Ooh, Bloods actually does get a kill there from Balcony. Nice. Nice pickup. He's going to rotate towards the balcony. We have 2 in archways right now, which is actually very big. Zealot nearly cutting them off, but he eats a lead sandwich right there and does get taken out. And okay, we have the terrorist executing towards B1's on site. He does get picked up. He had an opportunity to wreck both of them, but doesn't manage to actually execute it. And Bloods, Deline, are they going to eco? Oh, try and save? It looks that way, just. Yeah, just try and get some exit frags, pretty much. Deline is here on Banana. 2 of them are chasing him down, standing next to each other, so they will get the refrag. Well, yeah, that's the ideal, but 2 of them are quite low, so they do also have to be very careful. Only 1 is staying on the bomb. Okay. We're about to have the face-off. Zeet. Oh, he gets taken out. The second one's coming. Is he gonna fall as well? He will not. Experience gets the headshot there. And actually, one of them gets taken out by the bomb. With an AK. Which, isn't the biggest deal, since they do have money to drop, but still, like, you know, it's still like 4,000, 4.5 with the resources there. Alright, so at this stage, because Alien Tech has actually lost 6 rounds in a row, their bank is, or their money loss bonus is at max, and they've borderline got enough resources each time to buy, depending on, you know, if they get any kills and such, so pretty much what we're going to see is, like, just forced half-ass buys for the majority of this, until they win one. Oh, first kill does go to Zinx there, onto Orr. As he picks him on banana nades, and utility just getting chucked out. The bomb is kind of rotating. We do actually have a player, Zendi, in a very sneaky place. But the CTs kind of leave it open, so I think they have an idea. Scream's going to go for the peek. He sees him, doesn't get the kill. And he doesn't want to re-peek against a FAMAS, against an AK with the FAMAS. He should lose that trade. Does go for it, trying to pop flash. Takes a lot of damage. His teammate tries to back him up there from archway. He falls. There's one on site, and they know he's here. And he will get taken out. So now it's a 2-on-3. The bomb is about to be planted. Both CTs come from banana. And, like, there's still a lot of angles, so it's okay to come from the same place, but it's still going to be very hard for them, right? And it looks like they're actually just going to save here. They do have AKs, and they realize that, you know, the AK can actually make a big enough of a difference going into the next round. They can also drop now as well. That means, you know, they can have full utility on one of their players. For example, Zeline saves an AK, he's got 1200 in the bank, he's going to get 3400 from this, so he can drop an M4, have full nades for himself, and so can one of his teammates, so good job here. Benji's coming down, he's spraying with the Tech-9, doesn't peek. Like, rushing into T-spawn is very risky. there's, you know, you're just running into a massive open area from a very choked up point. So, okay, can the CTs stop the momentum of Dope? Or are Dope just gonna kind of steamroll them? If Sem runs in a row, it's gonna be over the top, and it's, you know, there's only like 2 runs left, so you're gonna do it now. Looks like we do have Terrace pushing up mid. They're just getting, or just trying to peek, you know, get an opening frag maybe. Oh, does peek right there as he has a smoke in his hand. Could have got taken out, but shot didn't connect. And yeah, they're just spraying through the smoke right now. The bomb is still down. They're looking for that weak link in the CTs. The CTs, I like it. They're staying quite far back. No one's really overconnected. Bloods gets one. I don't know if that was actually a through the smoke shot. Actually, it didn't look like it. And he does drop down to 7, so no. He didn't come through the smoke there. Okay, we have the bomb banana right now. Orr is leading the charge. Another Terrace has been taken out, so we're on a 5v2 situation. I think they can hear him. There's another smoke. He's going for it. Gets the kill. Kind of gets pop flash, but he's in the smoke. He runs straight to it and flanks his opponent. He didn't get seen there. Bloods is right by here. Oh man, he's about to get whackable. There's one. Second one. Maybe pop flash. Pretty good. But he's got 2 CTs right there. And he will not manage to get any of them. Great shot there coming out of Zil. He does connect with the head of Zendi. When the round. So finally, Alien Tech blow down the momentum train here of Dope. Mainly Zil. Dreamtastic. Is it Dreamstack? Okay. Zil Dreamstack. Yeah, again, 3 kills carrying his team in that round there. And let's see if they, you know, they can carry on the momentum. This is the last round, everything going into it. It will give one of the teams the lead going into that second half. We have Orps about to face off. And oh, Orps takes a shot that doesn't die. Hit him in like the toe. He was standing on the haystacks and Boom wasn't able to flip shot high enough to get the kill. But he gets picked off at the bottom of Banana. CTs have control of Banana, which is a very big deal because now they have the information and we can see one of the CTs is going to rotate back to A as Sphinx does get picked off. Nade's coming up. Zil is waiting here, rotates the perfect time in. And good pop flash. Actually, no, there was just a flash to buy him time, but, you know, was a pop. A good smoke here. Smoking off archery, smoking off library. Zil is right there. Oh! Oh man, you could see the AWP looking at him through the smoke there just after he tried to guess. And okay, one's on site experience, takes out Bloods just after his teammate got taken out by him. Now it's a 2-on-1. Zil is coming for it. He's gone M4. He will get taken out by Benji with the AWP. And we will go into the second half with an 8-7 scoreline. Now remember, this was Alien Tech's map choice. This is a map that they should have, you know, naturally led gone to victory on. They might be a little bit anxious about that. And okay, so what type of stack do we have? We have just a 3-on-2. Nothing crazy at Banana and B. And the Terrace, they're running all the way up mid. Going straight for it, not slowing down. And we can see one of the CTs is getting chased down. He does go to archway. But now the CT, the Terrace are pretty much in a great position. Green falls, taken out there by Zendi. He had low health. He was just, you know, delaying the charge from the CTs as well. Bomb gets planted in a 4v3 situation, but there's all getting taken out. Oh, Zendi trying to get the guy on balcony. Gets pretty much insta-dinked. And then Benji was the last man to fall, given, of course, Team Alien Tech the win in the pistol round, which is always a very, very big deal, because, of course, that should indicate who wins the next couple of rounds, so they should take this one and the next, especially as the T side, because, you know, you kind of need to save a couple of rounds, but we do have a buy coming out of the CTs. They're going pistol armor. Head armor on a lot of them as well, or two of them. Something you don't see too often is normally you get nade instead. Possibly. Okay. Terrorists are very spread out here. Bomb is dropped, so they're just prodding. They want to get a pick here. They've got the better guns, so they should be able to. The CTs, because of course they know they have to win this. And they don't want to give up, you know, a round. They obviously want to win anyway. They're playing it very, very slow, so... Oh, like, they're hiding back just to... force the terrorists to come to them, and then, you know, peek them, get the kill, hold the angle. And okay, we have the CTs, they're all coming. We have one right in pit here, and there's one above him. Oh, he comes out behind him, gets the curl, great shot there by Orr. Straight to the face of Scream. Oh, sorry, Zilin. And then we have just one T left. So this force buy looks to have paid off. Bloods is about to get flanked, he gets one kill before he falls. He's getting a little bit of extra cash, but that obviously was a ridiculously important round there for Dope. And to win that puts them in a very, very comfortable position. Okay. So what do we have here? Looks like more of a mid for the time being. They're just... Once again, gonna play it slow and wait for picks, I guess. You know, they're up against a follow by right now, and they have just Glocks going for a hard eco. So they're not really expecting much. One or two kills, I think they'll be happy with. Bomb is by himself on banana, very far forward, so that could have been risky. And okay, they're just Dylan just waiting for pretty much an opening here. Maybe one of the CTs pokes his head around the corner. If that happens and they get the kill, that's a very big deal. But great timing on that flame. Just as they were creeping to the top, and Orr will take out Sil there in boiler. So, you know, the terrorist go to peek, his face gets torn off. But they're going for it. All of them lining up. We have a pro 90 here, and they run into the meat grinder. There is one in pit. Gets a little bit of damage onto experience, I believe, there. Unfortunately, does not get the kill, so... You know, at least they didn't invest anything into that round. It's just a cheap... Oh, so it wasn't even... Like, they didn't spend a single thing, so it was just a full-on eco. And okay, so they go in for another buy. Here we got two Galleons, three AKs. Bit of a desperation buy, it feels. It's not like a... It doesn't feel like a force, it feels like a desperation. And we have just one T, where it's going to be bloody there, covering banana in case. But let's have a look. We got Owen Boiler. There's like two, three people standing just behind him on the other side of that wall. And Experience is up there covering the apartments. But okay, Pop Flash does go off. Great trades coming in there, as the terrorists will take a 3-for-2 at the end of that. And puts them in a great spot as they are on site. The bomb is about to be planted, and we have one CT coming from mid and one from archers. Okay, we have Benji here. Flaming pit. Oh, he's maybe about to get shot in the back. Bloods is coming down the stairs. Very good angle, and then, of course, yeah, they're out in the open anyway. Slinks on site, takes him out. Takes up the second one. His teammates were like, they weren't close enough to protect him if he got into a fight there, which you pretty much saw. But you know, like, if he had died, the CTs wouldn't have been able to defuse, because that's what they were covering. Which is pretty smart. It's like, you know, Zinx was just kind of like buying time in a sense if he did die. And all the other two players have to do then is just peek. When they maybe hear that defuse. Or at least the second time, right? Okay. So, Alien Tech winning a round. They put themselves back into the running of this. Like, it looked like it might have just been the end there. So the desperation buy did definitely pay out. There's an AWP at the top and mid. Scream. Oh, sorry. Yeah, Scream gets a great headshot there onto Zit. I nearly said them in the reverse order there because Scream has always been open on mid. But that was a great shot. Experience drops his gun, picks up the AWP here. And he is going to peek. Oh, one in Mexico. Oh, Scream gets the first shot onto him. Doesn't follow up with a headshot though. And it is 4v5 right now as the terrorists make their way up banana. It looks like that's where they're kind of going to execute to. They, like with the other two players up on A. Oh, we could actually have a confrontation here by Archway. The experience run in, he gets wrecked. He had the AWP as well, so that was, you know, that was a vital gun there. And now the A site is open. It's, you know, like there's three on B and there's three left. So the A site is completely uncontested, 5v3. And I think they're going to save right now, realizing it's going to be a bit hard to take this. We do have Zende walking down banana. He gets a kill there onto Zil. If he can get an AK, he's going to be happy with that. And ooh, just gets the AK there before his opponent can peek around the corner and ruin his life. But we have Zilean coming up banana right now. Bloods is with him. Zende trying to get that kill. Will fall. And it looks like they're going to play this a bit slower. Like, there's too many angles to come into, like, B and stuff like that, especially if there's not much time, so they don't really want to go for it. Yeah, if one of them was, one of the CTs were to peek there and you get the kill, then that's fantastic, but it, you know, it didn't come to fruition there, so jumping into round number 21, it is tied right now. Whoever wins this will take the lead. And it's been a little bit back and forth. But normally with each team winning like a lot of rounds in sync. Or in succession. And we do have just two pistols, swag, and two rifles here for the terrorists, for the CTs. Two of them getting taken out there, one on banana, one in apartments. Gives the terrorists either option now. Do they want to slowly rotate A? Like, they're both missing a man, they should be able to overpower their opponents, absolutely no problems either way. And, oh, Orr gets taken out there. Deet will get the return frag onto Zilean, falls as his teammate comes to back him up. The bomb is planted. 4v1 here. Damn. I was watching that from Benji's point of view. Like, it looked like he got shot before I even saw his opponent. Okay, so full eco coming out of the CTs. A bit of a stack as they all rush towards B. You know, they've got nades, they've got a couple of pistols. They're gonna probably nade stack. And they're just gonna fall on two sides. But okay, Benji gets one kill. Four of them get traded out, so there's the last one. And that will be 12-10 Team Alien Tech. As said, this is Alien Tech's map choice. Like, in my opinion, like, on your map, like, you have to win your map, right? Obviously, it, you know, you can still win your opponent's map, but I feel like winning your own map is a sign of dominance, you know? It's like, I'm gonna pick this map, I'm gonna beat you on it. Because if someone's like, I'm picking this map, and then they're like, yeah, I'm gonna destroy you. Sorry, like, your opponents destroy you on your own map, it's gotta be a bit unsettling a little bit. Okay, so four up on A stairs here at the back. The bomb is with them. They're all walking in sneaky sneaky. And okay, they're gonna go for it. One in pit will get the first kill. Experience gets traded out, but CT's there to even up the scoreline. He falls as he tries to get inside. Smoke will get dropped. Buds has tiny health, so he has to be very careful. He doesn't really want to engage here. And the bomb is in pit, so they're having a hard time getting it out. He gets chucked over the car. Bloods is gonna plant this, and at 12 HP, you know, he should be the bomb planter. Let's see, who do we have sneaking around? Okay, we have Scream up in apartment. Zende, they're actually both by library. I don't know if they're gonna go for this. Like, they have an AWP, so they really, like, they don't want to lose these. And they are gonna run away. I don't think the terrorists will chase them down, because they know it's Against an open and M4, 3v2, it's... You know, it shouldn't really go... Then. Like, they would maybe lose an open themselves, so it's... not as worthwhile. But now it's 13-10. Like, it's starting to become do-or-die time right now for Team Dope. Is it, you know, in a moment, like, if they lose this, it's 14-10. Then they're gonna be forced to... Like, it would be a forced buy coming out of them, so we'd have, like, FAMSs and stuff. Which you never really want. I think some friendly fire was just out there. It doesn't tell you if you do friendly fire damage, so... It's hard to say. Okay. Alright, so we got 4-man stack right now for Dope on A. Leaving, who do we have by himself? Benji with the op on bananas, or covering bananas. So he should be okay there. There's a couple of CTs slow creeping up it. The bomb is still towards A and now making its way towards B. So it looks like they've decided B is going to be the side of choice. Yeah, spam into the smoke. We've got Zeline all the way back by A stairs, waiting for the rotators. And with three of them on A, he should maybe see two of them. Okay, get ready. The executor's incoming. Is Benji gonna be able to get these kills? He gets smoked out. And a team kill incoming. Bloods takes out Zild. That was a very important moment, but it doesn't matter. Zinx gets the kill onto Benji, who's on top of Spills. Now the bomb is planted. The 4v3, the terrorist is obviously in a very good spot. And we do have one terrorist rotating all the way back. Banana. But, like, they know that angle is covered. They, like, the CTs have to come from one point of view. And they're actually gonna... They're gonna save again. Oh, sorry. I hit the mic there. That's... Like, I can see why they're saving, but now it's... It's getting scarier and scarier. Oh, Bloods gets taken out there. Gets a little bit of damage. Or does get the return frag there. So they made it a little bit more expensive. Yeah, to not lose any CTs would definitely be preferred. And now, it's 10-6. If Dope are going to do this, if they're gonna win the map without going into overtime, this is where they have to bring it back. This is the absolute point of no return. Otherwise, it's going to be overtime. Or, of course, the less favorable option, a loss in map number one here. But Team Alien Tech have been playing very well. The bomb going up second mid. And we have a couple of people chilling on banana, pretty much just, waiting for an opportunity. Ooh, a tiny lag spike came out there. I thought that could have been worse. And yeah, terrorists just, they're feeling out the CTs. Playing it very slow. They know they've got a comfortable lead, so they just don't want to piss it away and lose the map when they were so far up. Because that's what can happen. You get a bit antsy, you're like, oh, we're so close to winning, let's do this, let's rush them. And then you get wrecked and your momentum just gets it gets stopped stone cold. Alright. So very slow round coming out of the T sides. Like, at the same time, while running out the clock is cool because it makes, the CTs anxious and stuff. It gives you a very limited amount of time, so if you make a mistake, like, you're going to pay the price. So it's a bit, it's a high risk, high reward type of scenario. The smokes are coming out, they're being chucked towards Archway. And who do we have in pit? We've got Orr. Not going to get too much action as Orr. Oh, great kill there from Zendy. Waiting on the other side of the smoke. The terrorist jumped straight through it into his bullets. We do have Zeline up on balcony here. Trying to get something. We'll get picked off. One left in mid. Oh, he gets the kill. Drops down to 1 HP. And he, obviously he's not going to go for that. There's the round going to Dope. So after losing 6 rounds, they finally... get themselves back on the scoreboard. Pause. Maybe that was what the hiccup of lag was. Alright, so I just tapped out really quickly, because why not? Yeah, so hopefully it doesn't take long. it could be just his game crash for his quick moment, or you know, hopefully it, like, he didn't just like vanish, you know. So waiting for this. If he just vanished, you never know. Like, it could be computer problems. We could need a replacement to complain man down. If Counter Strike crashed, then it just takes a second. Alright, so there's Zeke rejoining. And Zeke, what team was he? Sorry, he was the CTs. Yeah, they definitely want him right now. It's kind of weird when you compare, like, StarCraft to Counter-Strike in terms of, warm-ups or waiting for games to go live and stuff like that. It's kind of weird, like, you have all the players in a server just like standing there and, you know, warming up, or sometimes just like frozen, just swapping their guns. So it seems really boring. We do have a bit of a B rush right now. Of course, a huge bank on the terrace. You know, they've got a full buy, they've got 5 AKs, no AWP, and a full set of nades each. So absolutely massive possibilities here for them. But Flame gets chucked out there, and that will stop them from executing. One of the CTs did rotate from A to B, and he has come back to A. So he kind of has a good idea of what the terrorists are doing. But yeah, at this stage, they're just, like, they know how close they are, so they don't want to, it's just to have a foolish mistake, you know? They just want to get that kill. That opening frag that opens up a bomb site. And then they want to take it. Okay, it's just like so many shots being traded out right now. Okay, experience does get whack-a-mole by, who was that? Blood's taking him out. Great shot from the top or bottom of mid. We have Celine in boiler room right now. He's in a good spot to maybe get a kill, as Zeke is just outside. So whoever picks first, probably going to lose this, and that's why they're facing off. Oh. There's a bit of a pop flash-esque in. I don't know if he knows there's one in boiler. And okay, we do have two terrorists getting picked off here from Banana. The CTs over-rotate though, and they leave just Zeke by himself on site. He's in a 3v1 right now, and he gets taken up by Celine on balcony, which is a very big deal. Now the bomb is going to be planted 3-on-3. This was an absolute must-win round. The dope. And pretty much, you know, every round was a must-win round. They do have the number advantage. Scream, trying to figure out where he can pop flash, goes for one. Oh! Man, Zendy just charging in there, he had next to no health, trying to desperately get that kill. And all will swap the AWP for an M4, gets taken out there. Perfect timing from Zaline, back up his teammate. Because if Zaline hadn't got that, I'm pretty sure, sorry. If, I don't know who actually got that kill. But if he hadn't got it, then Celine up in apartments would have been able to get the return and win the round. So now it's 15-11, match point 5, or 4 rounds left for the CTs to bring it back. And they are forced onto a pistol armor by not much utility. Some of them do. Like, Aura has a flame. So, a lot of utility for some of them. And the terrorists, like, they know how close they are right now. Like, last round they played it slow to make sure they made no mistakes. Now they're, like, they know their opponents aren't ecos. They know they're gonna win the round, or should. So they're praying through smoke, just get any damage done to make it that a little bit easier. So, like, they just don't lose to a pistol armor round. Because that would just ruin their day. Okay, experience gets the first kill. One deke gets traded out there by Zaline very quickly. Because, of course, you know, if you... you know, any of the pistols or any of the CTs take out a terrorist, they're gonna have a gun off them. We have, who is it? Zender on Banana here, fighting against a couple of terrorists through the smoke. Buying some time. We do maybe have a bit of a rotate. We have Celine. He was up in apartments or jumped onto the pickup there and just missed the one dig. Okay, Celine drops the smoke, makes a little bit too much noise, so they might have an idea that he ran away there. We have the execute coming on to B right now, and Zil, oh, Zil gets the first two frags, one through the smoke with a headshot, and that is going to be very, very hard to come back now for two pistols against a full rifle setup. He gets the first kill though. Jumps. Gets the second one. And oh my god, Scream gets taken out with a headshot from a mile away. The last one's towards Dark. It's gonna be Bloods. They know where he is. They gotta rush him. And they do get the kill. Are you joking? And they don't have a kit, but they should have that. Absolutely phenomenal. And the thing is, it's one of those things, like, if this was round number 10 or round number 18, okay, so, yeah, as I was gonna say, if that was like round number 10 or something like that, like, I feel like the pressure of them knowing it's, you know, if they win the round, they win the map, so they kind of folded under the pressure. We have just nades being chucked, a bit of damage being traded out, and an execute coming on to be here. As the first kill goes to the CT, Benji takes out Bloods. They do start peeking again, and a 1-for-1 trade now. Is this a 4v3? Zendy at the back of the site. He is going to get flamed. He's going to maybe be forced out. He runs forward instead around the side, and Scream will take him out. But 3-on-3, we have one terrorist very far away, and he is going to make his way up Bananas. I think they realize that all the CTs are coming from the same side here. Okay, nades, smokes, flames getting dropped. Nice flame coming out of Zil there as it lands on the steps, forcing the CTs into pit. And Zil's right behind them, they're jumping over the wall. One's on the grill, they're going for the fight here, and they both get taken out. Very well played there by Team Alien Tech. Very back and forth. Like big segments of rounds being traded there, like 6-7 rounds each at some parts in the game. So congratulations there to Alien Tech winning map number one, which, as I said, you know, it's their pick. They should have won that. The next map, I believe, I did have it written down. Next map is going to be Cobble.